Jupiter was tired of eating ambrosia and drinking nectar up in Olympus, and even a little weary of listening to Apollo's lyre and watching the Graces dance, he will go to Earth disguising himself as a mortal and look for adventures. On this particular trip, Jupiter had determined to find out how hospitable the people of Phrygia are.
I'm tired of this. I need some real food. Mercury! Let's go to Froggy and see how the hospitality is.
Oh, come on, can we be the poor wayfarers? Come on, it'd be fun.
And so they went to Phrygia as the poor wayfarers. They wandered through the land, knocking on houses, looking for food and shelter. All of the houses had denied them, but one old and kind couple, and they go by the names of Bacchus and Philemon.
We're looking for a place to stay and have food.
Jupiter ignores him and knocks on the door anyways. Amazingly surprised, Bacchus and Philemon let them in.
Please come in. We'll sit you two by the fire and we'll cook you some supper.
As Philemon went to go fill the bowl with wine, Bacchus went to go set up the table and bade their guests to sit.
Please sit down. We've lived here all our lives and we've all been poor, but we deal with it though, and we love living like this.
I shall be your waiter for today. I will fill up your cup if it's almost empty.
But no matter how many cups were poured out from the bowl, the level of the wine stayed the same. The old couple looked terrified, so they dropped their eyes and began to pray silently. Then, in quavering voices and trembling all over, they begged their guests to pardon for them for the poor refreshments they offered.
I'm so sorry for our refreshments, it's just mere water. Please, let me be the goose, you can watch us chase it around. My name is Go.
To catch the goose, however, proved beyond their powers. They tried in vain until they were worn out, while Jupiter and Mercury watched them greatly entertained.
Get the goose!
Go, 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 get him! Get the goose! You almost got him, you almost got him! Hold on! Get him!
Wow, I guess chasing a goose is hard work. Have you been entertained? Very well, my guest. Why have you stood up?
Then host to your gods, and all should we shall be rewarded. This wicked country, which despairs the poor stranger, will be bitterly punished. But you two will come, will not. You two, but not you two. Come outside, and I will show you and grant you the reward that seeks upon you.
To their amazement, the ECTC cottage had turned into a pillar temple. But one day they fell talking about the former life, which was hard and yet happy at the same time. Suddenly they exchanged memories as each saw the other putting forth leaves, then bark was growing around them. They only had time to cry, "Farewell, my dear companion." As the words passed their lips, they became trees, but they were together. The linden and the oak tree grew from one trunk. From far and wide, people came to admire the wonder, and always wreaths of flowers hung on the branches in honor of this pious and faithful pair.
Good old days were great.